energy.
More passion, more passion, more passion, more energy, more energy, more footwork, more footwork, more footwork, more passion, more energy, more energy.
Now, when you walk out and you go into that switch, this guy's going to sit with you. Try and go slower a little bit. Okay, he walks out, he sits and switches inside. Okay, good. Now he's going to sit, swim, pop up, and cradle. Okay, so you didn't get to see that on that side. So this time, Rocco's line up facing me. Line up facing me. Good. Riley, come on top. So now you walk out. Now when you go switch, stop. Yep, switch, sit, 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 sit. Good. Now right here in this position, you see how Ryland sat with him to try and sit behind him. Now Rocco comes underneath here. Now he's going to look for his swim cradle to the head. But now before you swim cradle, kind of sag yourself down a little bit more. Pop up. Now high leg over. Pop that head and go get that pin. So we turn that switch position of getting to this person trying to hold on to me. Now I get to pin him. Okay? So that's really good. You did a good job there. Okay, so bottom hand set. Face me this time so the camera can kind of see when you go into that switch. Okay, he's just running out, and then he gets that switch. Ready? Yeah, go fast. Ready? Go! Sit with him. Boom. Pop your head. Good job. Get that cradle. All right, Riley, go down. Rock will go on top. Okay, do it. Riley, face the current this way. Oh, yeah, face that way. That's good. Face there. Yeah. Ready? Go. Walking out. Sit. Switch. Good. Sit. Boom. Cradle. Pop that head. Good. Good job.
He's big! He's big!
I have a bar, and I'm looking for the half. Sometimes I cannot get this half. So what I'm gonna do is get a one-on-one. Roll the wrist in. Grab my own forearm and I'm gonna lean forward and start to put my head towards the mat. As I do this, I fall, throw the top boot in, get myself a set of backs.
Position, I'm gonna grab his armpit. I'm gonna pull armpit to armpit. I'm gonna fake an attack on the right side of his body. I'm gonna duck.
We'll be right back. start bending your elbows. Grab his wrist. Pull it in. When I say turn your hips, this is what I mean. Grab his wrist. Pull it in. Left shoulder, left ear on back. Right leg flip. Lots of pressure, right, Kupich?
Yeah.
Right here. Mark, stop putting your butt on the mat, bro. Put all your weight on his arm. You like it, Kupich?
No.
You love it. Two on one, put it on his back. Straight elbows. Pressure. Question. Questions? You're not looking at me. You're spinning around in a circle. Bend elbows. Come on. No, no. Try to get up. You have to try to get up. Inside chop. You can give him a little rib break if I need it. Turn the hips. Pressure. No hip on mat. Boom. This is the last time we're doing it, so pay attention. As he builds up even farther because the inside chop's not working, you have to have your knee in his butt. You have to be pulling on his ribs. It's not just this. It's a lot of this and a lot of this. This just helps me. Cross wrist, shoulder pressure. I'm free, free. Step behind him, shoulder forward, overhead. Get off to the side. So. Right in the beginning, grab his wrist, look across his back, then you let go with the second hand and grab his wrist. Put it on his back, straighten out your elbows. When that happens, sometimes I'll straddle him. If he's not really giving me a hip position, he's just laying flat, I'm gonna keep his arm on his back, I'm gonna pinch him with my knees, I'm gonna get underneath of his chest with this claw. As deep as I can get my shoulder underneath of his armpit and my hand on his back. I'm gonna block his arm with my knee and I'm gonna heel him over with my right heel. Right toe to left heel, keep the wrist on the back, pull your elbow up. If you're messing up all the other ones, don't even try this one. Just do the breakdown correctly and do the other ones. This is the most technical one. If you're having trouble with the breakdown, sideways to the wrist. Look across his back, circle towards his head. When he drops down, hip flip, release the thigh. Two on one. Push it across, straddle. Try to like kind of square up. If he's really square like that, this is where I'm gonna straddle. Underneath deep, hand on back. It's really important that you block and peel.
Walk.
As I push his butt off of his shoes, I'm thigh prying. I'm inside chopping. I'm moving my hips to the side. You guys don't want to hit this hip flip. When I hit this hip flip, all my lean's on the inside of his tricep. It hurts really bad. Get the 2-on-1 like a baseball. Get it good. Get off of his hand. Get on his wrist. Put him across his back. Straighten out your elbows. Put his knuckles on the mat. I like to immediately get the bulldog for position. It doesn't matter what move I'm trying. As he tries to switch his hips, that push off that arm a little bit more. That hold of death is same for the half. Use your other hand to go on the other side of the hold. Grab his wrist. As I circle over front, again, hole of death, grabbing my armpit. When that hole of death gets in there and you don't move your hand, it is really hard for him to stay alive. Your right knee, put it in his ribs and stack him up.
So if you're either getting extended on your shot or you're struggling getting to the shot, it's because your setups aren't very good. So there's a couple easy things that we can do. I call these touch and goes. I'm gonna take my lead leg hand, I'm gonna post on his head. Now, any of you guys that have wrestled for a while are saying you're not supposed to tie up with your lead leg lead hand. Here's why I'm allowed to do this. We're in our stance, I'm not collar tying him. If I collar tie with my lead leg lead hand, there's a lot of real estate here for Maddox to get in on my leg. I'm posting on his head. If Maddox shoots from here, really not much he can do. I'm not collar tying lead leg lead hand. That's a bad habit. I'm just posting lead leg lead hand on his head. Lead leg lead hand goes to his head. He's gonna pull it off. He's gonna hold it. He pulls my hand off. I'm going to take my free hand. I'm gonna grab his wrist, hand exchange. I'm gonna try to pull this towards my back shoe and step. What shot is this? Sweep single, single leg. There's my shot.
Damn. Oh, he's got my wrist. Oh, preventative medicine. Oh, he's got my wrist. He's too strong. Oh, he didn't get it that time, but he chops me down. Oh, he's gonna hit the cradle. Question.
Say there was only 5 seconds left in the match and he's ahead by one. The best move I know to get away in 5 seconds is a tripod Granby. Here, I'm gonna Swisher, change him over, come right back up into my Swisher Granby. If he's already on this side, my Swisher Granby is Swisher up, get away.
Back door. Peterson. Notice how it's a progression. The switch leg's not there. The back door's not there. He takes the Peterson. The switch ain't there. The back door ain't there. The Peterson ain't there. He rises up to the quad pod for the roll. Hip hops. Turn in. Quad pod. Roll. Perhaps he follows your roll. Follow with a standing. You need
captured the head again, brought him down. I dig in for that cement job. What he's looking for is to defend that elbow and bury it here. He wants to fight that position. All I do is change my direction. This hand that's under the arm changes to the tricep. Outside leg drops back. I want to make sure I keep my toes in the mat. I'm keeping the chin. I change direction on him.
can't do it. Boom, boom, bend this knee a little bit. I'm pushing up and stopping this foot underneath my hip. If I don't do that, and I start stepping like my feet like this, pretend someone's behind me, and I'm trying to, like, that ain't gonna work. You need to bend, push, step. The second back foot hits the mat, you down block. Quarter drop, boom, boom, boom. Flip leg, visualize the wrist, boom, boom. Change over, boom, 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 boom. You gotta move fast. And jump. Fast. Questions?
Crotch lock is one of my go-to single leg defenses when somebody's in deep on a single. I want to make sure my elbows are in tight and I'm committing to rolling through parallel. This is great to force a scramble or kind of discombobulate your opponent to make sure you get the upper hand when you roll through. The crotch lock is one of my go-to single leg defenses when somebody's in deep on a single. I want to make sure my elbows are in tight and I'm committing to rolling through parallel. This is great to force a scramble or kind of discombobulate your opponent to make sure you get the upper hand when you roll through.
On the Granby, I'm not gonna go all out roll. As you're circling, right before you go, you gotta clear this foot. If you put it right under your knee, it could still get caught. If you put it on the inside of your leg, it's definitely gonna get caught. If you put it on the outside of your leg, it will not get caught. You need to clear it and push off of it. When you clear it, you won't need the next move. The next move happens when this leg gets caught. If as you circle, you cross every time, it'll be clear and ready to push. When you push, you should push over top and land on your right hip. Two of a stance. It's the only one I'm hitting. Did you feel your leg almost get caught? You're gonna wanna over clear. In. Obviously, don't.
And the motion is not out, it's forward. So I'm going from here to here with that hand instead of crossing. So we step, and now next place to hit is our hip, out. And now I'm digging. I'm gonna remove that hand from the mat and I'm gonna chase the hips.
So when I go wrist to half, if my opponent's not letting me run this and he starts building up his base, I'm gonna come out to the side and essentially I'm going to pull him across, not on top of me. I'll pull him across and I'm gonna punch that half. So, knee goes flat. I go wrist to half. He starts building his base. I'm out to the side of the half. I'm going to whip him across, settle, punch the half, and take my time and get my pin.
I drive forward and I chop his elbow to the mat, Finn. What do I grab? And? My hand is on his what? Yes. I said it to you 500 times. It's not a trick question. When I circle towards his head and pull his hip, I release his hip and I grab his?
Wrist.
Wrist. Say it.
Wrist.
I'm going to straighten out my elbows and I have the bulldog. And Leon's trying to save his life. He opens up the same hole of window of opportunity. Instead of going half hand, I'm going to use my other hand to go in front of his elbow and grab his wrist. As I circle, I'm going hole of death on this side. I cannot exaggerate the need to get this hand in your armpit as high up as you could and keep it. Keep it nice and tight to Liam. Liam's alive? Yeah. He might be dead.
I start trying to get my hips in as he wants to get his hips back because I can't throw him from here. If his hips are in, I can throw.
I'm never showing up late again.
Any good wrestler, he's just going to keep his hips back, keep his hips back. This isn't as important with the push-pull because he thinks he's going to throw you, so he's keeping his ground. So you act like you're going to throw. If he doesn't stick his hips back, throw him like I just did. If he does get his hips back, you're going to take your underhook side, you're just going to swing it around. You're still keeping that over. Your under swings over. Boom. Looks like we're dancing, huh? You're looking throw, he's keeping his hips back.
And he gets his head up, he's asking for the cross face. If his head's low and drooped down, he's asking for over top of the head and brute style. You feel how much you're in trouble right now? As long as you get this position, Saban, you weren't getting this. As soon as you get this, he's pinned. Take your time. Keep his head covered. Get your elbow behind his neck and his knee. It's very important that your lock doesn't rotate. I can't even do it wrong. You guys rotate your lock like this. So your lock's behind his knee. And then he's sagging away like that. It's mainly because there's too much space in your lock. If I give him that much room, he's got that much room to move. If I take away the space, he got no option. My middle aim is take away Petrusca's options. That's how you win matches, guys. You gotta take away the dude's options. When I got him covered up, I gotta get that lock nice and tight. As I suck these elbows into my chest and I stop the mat, go ahead and try to get your hands away from me, Petrusca. Come on, do something. Do something, bro. He should be like just trying to breathe. But if you're not doing that, then it won't be done. You have to actively try to kill the man, and it works better. Question. Cradles on the same leg, it'll be the far leg. If he's down on his knees, I could push his butt into the shoes and just jam over top of him. It's kind of a little bit of position, but you could get it. The more he is like kind of being lazy, the better it works. The more busier guys, as I try to push over top, he's not gonna go to his head. If I could get my hand to his leg, then I could get it. Obviously, no, that's it. If I can't get his leg, it's not gonna work. But if I can get his leg, it'll work. So really the hardest part is just getting deep enough to get to his side. And then it's easy. I'm not long enough to be realistic for that, but I have hit this one a million times. As he rises up, left leg lead, circle left, left knee down. Here. Here. He stays down. He rises up. Right? Hands on it. Fight his hand with your hand. Put it on the mat. Circle up. Yeah, we really need to work on that, obviously. Sucker jab when he's over you. Spin out when he's under the arm. Questions. Get heavy on the lower back. Lift up the chest. Run my feet into him. Literally run your feet. You're not gonna do that. You're gonna put your knees right here and you're gonna go like this. Oh, I'm so strong. And oh, look at this, it worked, coach. He's on his back. This is never gonna happen. You gotta do the work. You gotta block the knee. You gotta pick him up just a little bit, but you really gotta run. You gotta move your, I'm using my whole body to smash his face against his knee. This is easy. Now rewind it. Go back to the other side. Push on him. With my left hip, I'm pushing on his right hip. I'm pushing him over. Same finish. Head in the temple, knee in the side, hip area, pull and push nice and tight. Now that's because Petruska looked away from me. He's looking away from me. Cross face cradle. Petruska got cradled last weekend. His dad is mad. He said, you get cross face cradled by old Joe again, you ain't getting no dinner. So he looks away. Where does he go? To freedom, right? Freedom! No, Turk. It's always Turk, guys. You just miss it. You miss it all the time. Freedom. Freedom? Cross face, cradle. Okay, go, run. Run to freedom. Turk?
Okay.
Everything's gonna come from when he's falling over. When he's not falling over, I have either one side or the other side. There's only two sides. I gotta move for each side. Got it. When he's flat, you got a couple more options. See that leg ride's impossible when he falls like that. No, that's what I want. That's what you should have done. If I try to elevate this heel, there's just no way it's gonna work. Rebuild. The only way it's gonna work is if he falls on his hip. When he falls on his hip, this heel's easy. Let me go. This heel's easy to rainbow. And then I'm in. So if he falls on his hip, you have the leg ride. If you're trying to get the leg ride in and he was on his belly, it's not that you're doing something wrong, it's you're just going down the wrong road. The leg ride won't work even if I was doing it. He has to be on his hip. So if he falls flat that way. If he falls flat like he did, I have the cross face and the bulldog, but this bulldog now is not usable. The cross face is still usable, so keep it. But you let go of the bulldog. You got options depending on where he's at. When I have a cross face and my hand's in the middle of his legs, I can attack this near leg or I can attack this far leg. It all depends on how his hips are. His hips are slightly turned into me. Now his hips are slightly turned away from me. When his hips are slightly turned away from me, when he keeps the arm and the kid bellies, you can hit the turn. Now, we didn't go over this, but when Kanoa fights his right arm underneath, you can go back into the leg ride. Heel to toe lock. This is the exact face points we hit when he broke him down. It's just on the other side. Then he turns back in. Now he's back in the turn. You see how that goes? Elevate the turn. When he turns back and forth, turn. Face points. Turn. Turn. Now keep turning, Kanoa. Low leg cradle. That's every move but the overhead cradle from a cross face cradle. Chain. I usually go like three deep. For whatever reason, I never put the five deep together. It's been scaring me in the face. As I do, I'm gonna get on his right side. It's very important that I make a corner with my feet. And my foot's not flagged out. When my foot's flagged out, my butt's gonna go to the inside. I don't want that. I want my butt to go to the outside of my foot. This is walking. When I corner the hip, my butt goes to the outside of that shoe, this knee comes up. I can usually get right in here. Face point. Corner. He has a corner, and I put my corner in his corner. Walk the far arm. Don't drape under the shoulder. Make sure you're above the shoulder. Under the shoulder is locking hands. As I sit him in my pocket, elbow up, knee up. Leg right in, frame the face. Bottom leg, left leg flips out. Push up on hand, not elbow. Heel to toe lock is best version. Bent knees, kick butt, leg right in toe. Free leg heel, not the other way around. He turns in the freedom. He realizes it's not freedom. It's a turn. Perhaps maybe he punches that right arm back through the hole. Freedom. Go free. No, not freedom. Back to the face points. Okay, he maybe goes to the other way again. Freedom. No, back to the turn. That turn and that face points is his shoulder twist away. Fight. He's always gonna fight with his arm. Thing of a tilt is important on the guys when they're really trying to fight. Gut wrench tilt. Side, over the shoulder, under the armpit. Pick him up, bump him with your thighs, get the lock. If I'm gonna roll right, I kind of want my lock slightly on the right side of his chest. I want my right shoulder on his back, my right ear on his back, and we're gonna run forward. When I run forward, this knee starts to come under. And then I just rotate. the knee comes up, shoulder goes down, the knee comes under, and then we just rotate and elevate. The rotating, like the scooting of a tilt, is important on the guys when they're really trying to fight. Gut wrench tilt, side, over the shoulder, under the armpit. Pick them up, bump them with your thighs, get the lock. If I'm gonna roll right, I kind of want my lock slightly on the right side of his chest. I want my right shoulder on his back, my right ear on his back, and when I run forward, this knee starts to come under, and then I just rotate. The knee comes up, shoulder goes down, the knee comes under, and then we just rotate and elevate. The rotating, like the scooting of a tilt, is important on the guys when they're really trying to fight. Gut wrench tilt, core side. Body's in the shape of an L. I want you to straighten it down. I want you to push it down under his butt. That way, not that way. You have to have two hands above his elbow. You have to have your elbow on the mat. You guys don't like to use this backstop. You need it. Your knee must remain straight. Base. Guillotine. You guys are really met. No, no. Break them down and earn it. Put your head this way, Cuppage. Turn your head. No, no. Stand. Let him stand. Put your head this way, boys. Please. They need to see your this side. You see those arms in here? Put your arm on his back. Pull that arm out. You guys don't put that arm in there. You just put his arm over your head. This is wrong. This arm has to be with your head. I said it a million times, you guys mess that up a lot. Flat. Power half. Don't move. You guys are not heel peeling. Watch him heel peel. With the heel to toe lock with wide knees. Not on his elbow. Fight. The other way. There's only that way. Turn that way. There's only one way, really, if he does it right. To the Turk. He fights back to the Mark Hall. You gotta move your arms, Cubbage. He goes flat. Mark Hall with the figure four. He builds his base. Split scissors. I believe that's all we got to. But you guys don't do the details. You got to step forward, step back. That's the hard part is getting this leg here. If you get this leg here, you have this right wrist. You're going to roll right. Pierce. Easy as it is. Switches with your right hand on the mat. With your right hand on the mat. Incorrectly. Do it. The right hand does not belong on the mat. That right hand belongs under the leg. Do it right. Do it right now. That leg is your handle. You're pulling yourself around him by that handle. Break. Break down wrist ankle. Hips up. Arm underneath with the head, push off the mat. I like to push off the mat and walk that hand over his head. We have had multiple people pin themselves here. One of our best. When you have a throw hook and it's slipping out, you gotta know it's an issue. Long leg toe hook. When it slips out, straighten out your right knee. That toe's about to slip out. I need to fix it. My right leg toe has to be crooked on something all the time. The easiest thing to do is go to a heel to toe lock, get flat. A heel to toe lock is wide knees. My right leg ride is gonna be the tug, not the other way around. The leg ride leg will be the toe part of the heel to toe lock. Get flat. When I pick my right knee up, that creates the pressure. If I can get his right hip thigh up, then I know I have the pressure. He won't be able to build a base. It's easy face points. Try to get the long leg toe hook back in if that's your style of riding. If you have him on his back, last move, power bar, he starts finding that toe hook out. Better than the heel to toe is the toe to knee. Call it figure four. We did a figure four, flat, with a Mark Hall. The only difference is my left knee straight when he's on his belly, bent when he's on his back. Long leg toe hook. Straighten out his knee, my toe comes out. Figure four, bent knee. I could use that new toe to find the old. But what you really want to do is bent over, you could also hit that Peterson, but what you really want to do is kind of cheat forward, leave your feet behind and start falling over. The second my hand hits, his hands have to unlock. As soon as my hand hits, his hands unlock. I hit that hip ice, I got a falling switch. The forwardness makes his weight go forward. But when I start to fall, I want to leave my feet back. When his weight keeps going forward, and I hit that hard cut out from underneath, usually his face goes down in the mat where it's locked. I'm not going to hit him fast. I'm not really supposed to be hitting hip highs. When I don't want the falling switch, I have the bump switch, which is even harder as a drill. Again, works really good in the live when the guy wants to waste. When I'm all bent over, if I'm going to hit a right-handed switch, I have to use my left elbow to shove his weight to the side. Keep those hands locked, Ari. If his hands aren't locked, this won't work. When his keeps his hands locked and I find his leg, I can walk my feet out front. When my feet go out front, my butt goes down, that lock will break and I bounce off the hip. There's a drastic difference of feet back, fall shoulders forward, touch and cut. Complete opposite of feet back, shoulders forward, is feet forward, shoulders back. When I have the feet forward, the shoulders back, and I find that leg, I keep walking my feet forward. Butt down. You guys are gonna go to your knee. Butt down. Pull yourself around. Kick him, hit him back. Power position, rise up. He locks his hands. You fall forward, find a switch leg. Kick, falling switch. Bump switch. Hold your hands tight, kid. His left, his both knees.
Thank you.
guys, that underhook is what you want. I'm telling you, it's there. Look for it. If he hooks my leg and I hate a knee slide stand up or it's not working, I need to bring my foot over his other foot. I gotta keep his leg trapped. Carry on. Oh, damn, it only hurts more when we do that. You know that, right? So, if he hooks my leg, I'm gonna set my other leg, or my that same leg, over his other leg. Lift my foot up, drop him on his hip. When he drops to the hip, I gotta collect his foot, keep his foot in the air. Drop my hip in his armpit, find the turn. Punish the area. Boom, boom. Shove your hips into him. Elevate. Hip down at the end.
Tick, tick, boom. We're bringing in.
In that base, I'm chopping his arm, I'm bumping his butt, I'm collecting his cross wrist, he rebuilds. When he rebuilds, I push his wrist across, open up that hole, punch through the hole with the fist. It's an arm bar with wrist control. You could get the bar first, then the wrist, it's not as good. If you get that cross wrist, you push it across, get that bar, it's a little bit better. When I pull his wrist across and I straighten out my arm bar elbow, it should get kind of tight. So I got basically five options. So this is like a segue between arm bar and tilt. We are gonna tilt him, but we're using an arm bar. When I tuck my head and my elbow on the near side and roll through, my knee's up here on his hip, my other knee's in between his legs, my shoelaces are claw footing his ankle, you have a roll through tilt. Notice I'm like a T, I'm not laying next to him with my knee in the wrong spot. I'm elevating and scooting that knee to the proper tilt position. Now, if I don't want to roll it, if I don't want to roll the near side, I can jump to the far side. I like my foot underneath his laces and my knee like either on or in front of his thigh, and then I'm just lifting up that knee and that laces. You can suck it back. In that base,
I start coming up. That's how aggressive it's going to look like. Right when I feel that boot come in, I slam and come back. I start pivoting up to my tripod stand up. As I pivot up to here, he's a leg rider, he slips the leg in. Immediately, I'm going to throw this knee down and bring my opposite leg up. Immediately, knee goes down, opposite leg goes up. Now, as I do this, I'm gonna land on my left elbow because my goal is to get him to fall over my left shoulder. So my knees switch and I land on my left elbow. This left knee's hitting, this left elbow's hitting at the same time. And the goal is to get him to fall over this top of the shoulder here.
Will here, and he can feel that coming. He does not want to let me get his arm up here. Once I get my head underneath, it's over. Sometimes he buries his arm underneath his belt. Can you spin? So, see, let's get half circle, boys. Half circle. When he's burying his arm, you could take some time to pull it out if you really want a guillotine, but you could reach underneath and grab his wrist like a ball and chain. When you reach underneath and grab his wrist like a ball and chain, if he's oriented the way that he's oriented with this left far hip on the mat, I'm gonna roll my right hip over his head. Anthony Robles roll style. That guy's not very good at the leg rod, but he is very good at the Jarella. So
yes, he is.
When I have the wrist, you're gonna be in his crotch, most of you guys, straight out your leg, straight over my body. You don't want this. This leg draped over, start pushing off your right hand. This is not good. I gotta shorten out this lock to his knee. There's a big difference, right? When I have that lock, my forearm is in the back of the knee pit, my right elbow right here in the rib. Wrist on the elbow. I'm not trying to really spread him out. I'm trying to push his knees to the mat over the shoulder. So it's a ball and chain plus a leg ride. If you guys know who Anthony Robles is, he's a two-time champ from Arizona State. Ankle through the crotch, grab wrist. I want to drive forward to bring his knee into his armpit. When I drive forward and bring his knee into his armpit, it works a lot better. You can keep the right leg straight, but it works a little bit better if you go bent leg, figure four. Definitely watch your own back. Push off your back foot to turn your ribs, pull your right elbow into his rib, and you have him. Left foot on the mat, right elbow in his rib, you have him. Don't worry about spreading him out as much as possible. Worry about pushing his knees to his shoulders as much as possible.
So I've stepped out a couple inches with my outside leg. One foot goes in front of the other. I've captured hand control. And now when I tuck, it's not a forward roll. I want to be doing a cartwheel motion top of my head. And this hand that I'm posting on is going to head back to the crotch here. So slowly. And now we capture our Peterson and we're back into securing this position.
Knee pound right in between his legs. Knee pound, dump!
There you go.
There you go. Happens when a guy locks too deep. Knee pound, dump. Very nice.
The knee, secondary hand goes to the shoe. Pull it into the pocket. The trapped leg catches his leg. Push off back foot. Pop by belly button. Go.
Moves where you can pin guys that are way better than you. I have a friend, his name is Brendan Fitzgerald. I was wrestling a guy named Stevan Miocic. Stevan Miocic is very good. Brendan Fitzgerald was not Stevan Miocic, but hit the Big Mac and pinned him. You're gonna take your right hand and reach through. This is what we tell you guys not to do 99.87% of the time. For this move, we're going deep. My free hand shoots through his legs, thumb down. All we're gonna do is roll to the left. Shoots through his legs, thumb down, roll, punch this to the mat. Colton, how tight is this?
Same side, get a tight waist, roll them through, sink the half. Try it.
Right here, so I'm gonna sprawl down,
it up to the waist, pushing in. I'm just gonna drop this left hip to the mat and just fall. All that force is gonna come from him pushing into me. So he comes up around my waist, he's pushing into me, I'm just gonna drop my weight. Single.
All the way up in his armpit with that forearm. On the neck, on the shoulder, off my hip. I'm trying to drive his right shoulder down so I can hit the sub back or the one rep. Levi ain't having it. He pushes off that right hand. Push off the right hand. You see how this pressure stops him from doing that? You gotta get that. I'm gonna break that arm off. Now, if I don't have correct pressure, because my hip's on the mat, or I'm not pushing on his neck good, that right arm's gonna come out and push off that right hand, Levi. He knows if he pushes his right shoulder off the mat, I can't do the other two moves. When that right shoulder comes off the mat, it's a window of opportunity for the half. When I got a nice tight bar up in his armpit and his half, I can crank him over to the stack. All I'm doing is punching the mat, and I'm knee ramping him up with my right knee. I'm pushing him up, his hips away and up. I don't want to push him too much over top. I want his butt right in the air. If I can't stack him, I'm going to jump the side. It's really important that I keep this arm bar tight up in his armpit. If his elbow starts to pop out, it's not going to be as tight. I'm going to cover that elbow with my armpit. As I punch the mat, I'm going to set my one leg over top. No knees. Head and toes, straight half hand.
Let's say I get into the front headlock and this guy starts to step this leg up. I'm gonna chase that corner and immediately lock my hands. From there, I'm gonna step up and I'm gonna tuck the heel, and now my head is gonna go through the backside of my partner, and I roll through. Now from here, you notice there's some space in between his legs. I'm gonna walk to his head and step through the space and finish the pin.
Thank you.
get that wrist the way that you want it, you're trying to push this across, he knows if he puts his hand in his back pocket, I got all the things we just did. Sometimes he tries to separate that arm, sometimes he's trying to pull that wrist out. When you try to pull that wrist out, that hole opens up. I gotta punch through that hole. You guys know this move, but if you get it and you can't score with it, it's a shame. This sucker should score points. The reason it doesn't score points is you're not in a fist and you're not deep. If your arm is just like wrist deep and you're not making a fist, your elbow joint bends in there, it doesn't cause any pressure on Levi. If I don't create any pressure, he doesn't have to move. When I punch it deep as I could, I cross his back and I make these knuckles, see how I can turn his shoulders now? I can turn his shoulders with it without even moving my body. I cannot do that wrist deep, limp wrist. It has to be elbow deep, strong wrist. I'm grinding those knuckles into his back. I basically have the same options, but not the standing tilt. And I have additional options that you can't do with the other lock. Rebar is different than cross wrist. He pulls out the cross wrist, you punch through the rebar. It's similar in that I can roll it through on this near side. My elbow's tucked, my head's tucked all the same. At the end, I don't have to really elbow pinch because the rebar is holding him in. So the elbow pinch is not the same.
Everybody, doesn't matter how good you are, I hit it on many kids. First, you need a tight waist and get a little high on your opponent so it gives him confidence to post up for an easy escape. Second, lace that near leg with his near leg, reach over and grab his knee. Take your far leg that you would normally cross body ride with and kick his arm out from underneath him, making him fall on his head, which puts him perfectly into the flattest spladle you can possibly get, better than a single leg. You can hit this.
Yeah, hip highs. Head and toes, don't move. This left arm is what I mean by flat. But you have to actually pick it up and push it away. Look at it, he has wrist control, which is better than a wrist grasping. That's his weak, yep, thank you. Now, he's gonna go to his right knee and pick his head up. No, stop, I said go to your right knee. Go to your right knee and pick your head up. And go behind me. That's what you're doing. That's what everybody usually does. You almost broke my arm because you did it the right way and I resisted. That's the whole point. Did you feel that?
No, not really.
You did?
Because I'm too strong.
Yeah, that's right. Head and toes. Now listen, go on your knee. Get your head up. That happens to you? I bet you it does. Hip highs. Head and toes. Drop your knee. Nothing happened with him. Nothing good happened. When you drop your butt, you're right. When you drop your butt and you pressure push on my back, when you pressure your back sitting like this, I can't rotate my wrist. Let me do it. I can't rotate my wrist to get on his stomach because my arm's like this. But if he's on his knee, get on your right knee. all of a sudden I could do that. So
double underhooks. We're right here. Now, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna pull down with one underhook and up with another one, like a steering wheel, like this. Now, when he moves, when he steps his foot, I'm gonna put my foot in front of it to catch him. So instead of him stepping on the ground, he's gonna be stepping around, his foot's gonna get caught, and he's gonna flip his upper body over top of that. Double underhooks. If I go to step, we'll go slow. I go steering wheel, my foot comes out as I step. So my left foot stepping around, I'm pulling with the arms, my foot is blocking him as he steps. So as he steps, my foot catches and I pull him right over. So we've got double underhooks here. All right, I'm stepping around, catching, and covering on top.
Switch the hands in the middle. Walk, 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 lean. Switch. I'm gonna lean my back into him, and I'm gonna stretch his arms forward. I'm gonna walk, and now I'm gonna pull everything down on that. I'm gonna lean back into him. I don't wanna like be like this for you to like pull me back, right? Like, I don't wanna do that. Okay, and I want to be square when I do this. Okay, I don't want to have my hip off to a corner. I want my hands to be in this. Okay, I'm gonna walk away, and then I'm going to lean forward just like that. I'm taking a seat off the mat just like this. Okay, now I'm gonna get straight to my forehead, keeping his hands connected.
Tuck your chin.
Get to the front of the mat. I hit my switch.
Go ahead. Yep, a little bit of motion. That's exactly what it should be. Blast, sprawl. Stuff his head a little bit. You feel your head underneath. Now, slide those knees in. Come out the back door. Yep, come in. You're good. You're good. Now, that left hand grabs the shoe. Now, buckle it into your pocket. Yes. Go ahead, Malcolm. A little bit of fakes, a little bit of motion. Tap. Sprawl, sprawl, sprawl. Stuff his head. Stuff his head. Good. Slide those knees in.
Questions, big fish. You like when I torture the
see the wall. Right foot creep over, walking with it, eat a wall.
You still blowing.